Hello students, how are you? I hope you all are fit and fine. So dear students, stay home, stay safe, keep washing your hands, keep sanitizing your hands, keep wearing your mask, don't go outside unnecessarily. Very soon we will be once again in the school. Offline classes will be starting very soon. Be positive. Keep studying, keep completing your work, and that's all. Okay, so let's hope that very soon we will see you each other once again in offline classes. So, as we are going through chapter 3 in Flamingo, Deep Water, written by William Douglas. As of now, in this story, we have seen this lesson, Deep Water, has been taken from an autobiography of William Douglas, the writer. Name of autobiography is Of Men and Mountains. Okay, written by William O. Douglas. In this story, in this essay, which we are going through, William Douglas shares his experience of drowning in a pool. First, he tells us when he was 3 or 4 years old, he went to a beach in California with his father. He was standing at the beach, then waves of the water knocked him down and swept over him. Since then, he had a great fear. He had developed a great fear of water. Later, another incident took place when he was 10 or 11 years old. He decided to learn swimming. That is why he started going YMCA pool. As Yakima River was very dangerous, as suggested by his mother. His mother kept on warning him against Yakima River. She kept on telling him about each drowning case. So she, on the other hand, she was warning him against the danger of Yakima River. So William Douglas decided to learn swimming in YMCA pool. YMCA, I have told in my previous videos, I had told you the full form, Young Men's Christian Association. One day, when he reached earlier to YMCA pool, he was sitting alone there. Then a boy of 18 years came, Brusher means a boy who is argumentative, having a good, physique, healthy, muscled boy of 18 years came and he threw the writer William Douglas at the deeper end of the pool. So when the writer William Douglas was drowning, he decided to hit the bottom and come to the surface of water, and then by paddling his hands and feet, he would reach to the edge of the pool. But it did not happen. He tried three times. Whenever he touched the bottom, He tried to do it. He came up words, but he was unsuccessful to come to the edge of the pool. So finally he started feeling dizzy. He started going into unconsciousness. He started getting unconscious. Then let's see what happened next. Page number 27. Second paragraph. Then I started down at third time. The narrator started going underwater. The third time I searched for air but got water. So he searched for air because he was under the water. So that is why he took water inside. The yellowish light was going out. So that yellowish light which he experienced earlier, that was going out. So simply these lines suggests us that he was getting unconscious. Then all effort ceased. All his effort ended. I relaxed. Even my legs felt limp. Even his legs started, he started feeling that his legs became lifeless. Limp means lifeless. And ceased means ended. Let me write down here. Ceased means ended. And the next word is limp. Limp means lifeless. Limp means lifeless. So his feet, he felt that his feet became lifeless and blackness swept over my brain. And there was only blackness in his brain. He could nothing but blackness everywhere. So he started feeling drowsy. He started feeling dizzy. He started getting unconscious. Then all effort ceased. All effort ended. I relaxed. Even my legs felt limp. And blackness swept over my brain. I wiped out fear. It wiped out fear. It wiped out terror. Now he had no fear. Now he came out of fear and came out of terror. Now he had no fear, no terror. There was no more panic. It was quiet and peaceful. Now when he started, getting unconscious, getting drowsy, getting dizzy. Now everything was, peaceful and quiet. Quiet and peaceful. Nothing to be afraid of. This is nice to be drowsy. To go to sleep. No need to jump. Now this is nice for him to sleep. To be drowsy. And no need to jump. Too tired to jump. Now he had become too tired to jump. It's nice to be carried gently, to float along the space. Now he was feeling that he was floating along the space. He was not in water. He was floating along the space. So these lines tells us that now he was feeling drowsy, become unconsciousness. He was, we can say here, about to die. Okay, so his senses now, gradually, they were stopping working. Tender arms around me, tender arms like mother's. So he felt soothed arms like his mother. Now I must go to sleep. I crossed to oblivion. I crossed to oblivion and the curtain of life. So he crossed the oblivion. Oblivion means the state of being unaware. Oblivion means the state of being unaware of what is happening in surrounding. Oblivion means the state of being unaware of what is happening in surrounding. So now I crossed to oblivion. Now he was unaware of what was happening in his surround, and the curtain of life fell and his life came to an end. Now he felt that his life came to an end. The next I remember, I was laying on my stomach beside the pool vomiting. After that he could remember nothing. The next which he remembered that he was laying on the stomach beside the pool and vomiting. Then these lines tell us that someone saved him. He was taken out of the pool, and when he came into consciousness, he saw that he was laying on the stomach beside the pool and vomiting. The chap that threw me in was saying, that threw William Douglas in, he was saying, but I was only fooling. He said, I was just making fun. I seriously didn't mean it. Someone said, the kid nearly died. Be all right now. Let's carry him to the locker room. Then someone said, this kind of joke was very terrible for the child. The child was nearly died. Be careful now. Be all right now. Let's carry to the locker room. And someone instructed to that boy to bring the child to locker room. Several hours later, I walked home. I was weak and trembling. So after several hours, the writer William Douglas walked home. He was weak and trembling because of that terrible experience. I shook and cried when I lay on bed. So when he was laying on his bed, he was because of that fear of drowning experience. He was shouting on his bed. I couldn't eat that night. For days a haunting fear was in my heart. So for days he experienced that haunting fear. The slightest exertion upset me, making me wobbly in the knees and sick to my stomach. So the slightest exertion made him upset and making him wobbly. Wobbly means feeling weak. Wobbly means feeling weak. Okay. So the small exertion was feeling him weak in the knees and sick to my stomach. So because of that terrible experience, he had developed a great fear, which did not last for many days. I never went back to the pool. So after that incident, he never went to the pool. I feared water. I avoided it whenever I could. So he had developed a great fear from water, and he avoided going to the water. A few years later, I came to know the waters of cascades. Cascades means here waterfall. Cascades, waterfall. So after a few years, he came to know about cascades. I wanted to get into them, and he wanted to get into that those waterfalls. And whenever I did, whether I was wading the Teton or bumping river or bathing in warm lake of the goat rocks, the terror that had seized me in the pool would come back. So whenever he tried to swim, he tried to go into the water, any water body, like names of some rivers are given here, whether he was wading the Teton or bumping river, or he wanted to bathe in a warm lake of the goat rocks. So that old terror came back. So whenever he tried to go into these rivers, his old terror used to come back. It would take possession of me completely. So that fear seized him completely, took possession, took under its possession completely. So William Douglas was taken in the possession of fear completely. The fear that he experienced in YMCA pool, every time it seized him. My legs would become paralyzed. His legs would become lifeless, paralyzed. Icy horror would grab my heart. And icy horror, the horror which he experienced in the pool, so it was like it was grabbing his legs, grabbing his heart. So whenever he decided to go into these rivers, the old terror came back and it was grabbing his heart. Now look at the next paragraph. What happened next? This handicap stayed with me as the years rolled by. So this fear stayed with him for several years. In canoes of main lake fishing, landlocked salmon, bass fishing in New Hampshire, trout fishing on the Deschutes and Metolius in Oregon, fishing for salmon on the Columbia, at Bumping Lake in the Cascades, wherever I went. So further, the narrator tells us that this fear continues for several years whenever he went, as he had described here the names of several rivers. So So whenever he went for several rivers and variety of different variety of fish. Okay. So whenever he went for fishing for langlog salmon, it's a type of fish. Bass fish, it's also a type of fish. In New Hampshire, trout fish, these are the different types of fishes. Dew shots and metallias in Oregon, fishing for salmon on the Columbia. So wherever he went for fishing, this fear continued. At Bumping Lake in the Cascades, wherever I went, the haunting fear of the water followed me. So this haunting fear of water followed the narrator, the writer William Douglas. It ruined my fishing trips, deprived me of the joy of canoeing, boating, and swimming. So it kept the writer away from canoeing, boating, and swimming, and it spoiled narrator's journey for fishing and for these trips for canoeing, boating, and swimming. So thus he could not enjoy this water sports, these water trips, because the haunted fear grabbed him, because that tremendous fear grabbed the narrator. I used every way I knew to overcome this fear, but it held me firmly in its grip. So the writer William Douglas tried every way to overcome this fear, but this fear gripped him and did not leave him. He was in a great clutch of that fear. He had tremendous fear. He could not overcome that fear. I went to a pool and practiced 5 days a week, an hour each day. The instructor put a belt around me. So now, he went to a pool and he hired an instructor. He practiced 5 days a week, an hour each day. He hired an instructor to teach him how to swim. The instructor put a belt around him. A rope attached to the belt went through a pulley that ran on an overhead cable. So you must have seen pulley over which the cable was running, and by the help of that rope, the narrator was able to swim in the water. So it was the technique of the instructor to teaching him how to swim. He held on the rope end of the rope, and we went back and forth across the pool, hour after hour, day after day, week after week. On each trip across the pool, a bit of the panic seized me. So when he was learning to swim, at some points he had to face his old fear. His old panic seized him. Each time the instructor relaxed his hold on the rope and I went under. Some of the old terror returned and my legs froze. Some of the old terror returned, or when narrator was learning how to swim, and once again his feet, once again his feet had frozen. It was 3 months before the tension began to slack. So it took him 3 months to slack his tension. Then he taught me to put my face under the water and exhale. After he overcame his fear, his panic, then instructor started teaching him to put his face under the water and exhale, and to raise his nose and inhale. So the instructor started teaching him different techniques as he was teaching. So it is also a part of his technique. I repeated the exercise hundreds of times. Bit by bit, I shed part of the panic that seized me when my head went under water. So bit by bit, he was trying to overcome the panic, and he was shedding the panic which seized him. So bit by bit, he was trying to overcome the fear, the old fear, the old terror, the panic which seized him. Next, he held me at the side of the pool and had me kick with my legs. So next, he held the writer William Douglas at the side of the pool and had him kick with his legs. So using different technique, the instructor was teaching William Douglas how to swim. For weeks, I did just that. At first, my legs refused to work, but they gradually relaxed, and finally, I could command them. So in the beginning, he could not, his legs, he could not use his legs because of fear, because the panic seized him. So that is why he could not, because he was feeling extreme fear. Because of that, he could not move his legs. Okay, but gradually he overcame his fear, and now he was able to move his leg, to paddle his legs too. Thus, piece by piece, he built a swimmer. So thus, bit by bit, piece by piece, the instructor made a swimmer out of Douglas. And when he had perfected each piece, he put them together into an integrated whole. So when first one by one, when the instructor had taught everything, then he told Douglas to do the things all together, to use the techniques all together. In April, he said, "Now you can swim. Dive off and swim the length of the pool. Crawl, stroke." So it was the month of April when finally the instructor declared that now William Douglas could swim. I did. The instructor was finished. And at this point, the instructor finished his training. But I was not finished. The instructor had finished his training, but the writer William Douglas, he was not finished. I still wondered if I would be terror-stricken when I was alone in the pool. So still he was thinking that when he would be alone in the pool, so whether he would be overcome, he would be overcoming to the fear, he would be able to overcome to the fear or not. I swam the length up and down. Tiny vestiges of old terror would return. So he swam the length up and down. Tiny vestiges, a trace or remnant of something, that is vestiges. Vestiges, let me write it on the board. Vestiges. A trace or tiny remnant of something. Okay. So when he was when he was swimming, then at some points, a tiny remnant of that fear came back, of old terror would return. But now I could frown and say to that terror, trying to scare me? Well, here's to you, look, and off I would go for another length of the pool. So at some points when terror used to come, now William Douglas wants to tell us that now he was quite confident. He was very confident and he was able to overcome his fear. So it's all about this video, dear students. In my next video, I'll explain the remaining paragraphs of this lesson. Thank you for watching. See you tomorrow.